So let's review how to calculate molar mass using the molar mass table. I'm gonna choose calcium carbonate since that's what we're working with in the chalk lab. So of course, first thing we have to do is make absolutely certain that we have the correct formula for the compound whose molar mass we're trying to determine. If you don't have the correct formula, you're not going to get the correct molar mass, and that creates problems with future calculations that you would be using the molar mass for. So calcium is a plus 2 ion, carbonate's a minus 2, the formula is CaCO3. Now remember the table, I think you should rely on this table, although you can do some of this work on your calculator, obviously. The table is really important initially in terms of helping you learn how to use, or calculate, I should say, the molar mass for an element. So we have the element, we have the number of atoms, and we have what's called the gram atomic mass. That's the mass off the periodic table of that particular element. These two values are going to be multiplied, so we'll get what we call a total, and then we'll add all those totals up. Now this total, this is going to play a role in a concept that we're going to take a look at after we finish the chalk lab. Each one of these individual totals for the individual elements will allow us to calculate something called percent composition. That's a concept that we'll learn after the chalk lab. So we've got calcium, and remember, you list the element once and you just list the symbol for the element under this first column. We got calcium, we got carbon, and we have oxygen. One atom of calcium, one atom of carbon, three atoms of oxygen. Make sure you're checking your formula carefully as you do that. Our gram atomic mass for calcium is 40.01. Now these numbers are going to vary a little bit, only down at the decimal value, depending on the periodic table that you're looking at. Don't forget to include the unit grams and keep moving that unit as you move through the table. You're also going to, I'll refer to it now and then I'll reinforce it later, you're also going to start using the formula of the substance that you're dealing with as part of the unit. That's extremely important for reasons that will become more clear as we move through this lab on making chalk. But our carbon is 12.01 grams and our oxygen 16 grams. And we're going to get our totals here. So it's 40.01 since we only have one atom of calcium. It's 12.01. We only have one atom of carbon, and we get 48 grams contributed by oxygen. Now remember, what we're doing here is calculating molar mass. So when I said 48 grams contributed by oxygen, I mean 48 grams for every mole of chalk of calcium carbonate. So that gives us a total, if I did my math properly, of 100.02 grams. Now here's where I want you to start using and continue to use the formula for the compound in question. So the molar mass of calcium carbonate is 100.02 grams of calcium carbonate. That's what this unit is indicating. And that's equal to, since we call it molar mass, it's obviously equal to one mole, remember the abbreviation for mole is MOL, of calcium carbonate. Extremely important, again, that you identify the substance and attach it to the unit. Okay, so here's the new technique. Make sure you pay attention to this carefully and go back over the video if you get a little bit stuck. So suppose I wanted, instead of just one mole of calcium carbonate, 2.5 moles of calcium carbonate. I'm going to do a dimensional analysis problem to get myself there. So I begin with my starting information. Similar to solving a proof in geometry, you begin with your given. And I just said 2.5 moles of my substance in question, so I'm going to write that unit out here, calcium carbonate, or write the formula, I'm sorry. And I'm doing a dimensional analysis problem. So I set up my dimensional analysis grid, and one conversion factor is necessary here, and it comes right from our molar mass calculation. I want moles to divide out. Well, I have an equality here, and remember, any equality can be used to establish a conversion factor. You simply have to determine which member of the equality is going to be in the numerator and which member is going to be in the denominator. The denominator is the item you want to get to divide out. The unit that will be in the numerator is the unit you're desiring. So if I said how many grams would 2.5 moles of calcium carbonate be, then I want my grams in the numerator here. So I'm going to put my 100, this comes right from the molar mass table up above, my 100.02 grams of calcium carbonate.